Hi friends, let us look at the one of the best Jacobean tragedies of all time, that is the Changeling. Now talking about the Changeling, it is the one of the powerful psychological tragedies and one of the best tragedies of English Renaissance. Now talking about the Changeling, it is the collaborated work of Thomas Middleton and William Rowley. According to scholar named as Pauline Wigeon, Thomas Middleton wrote a main plot, which is a tragic plot, while Rowley wrote a subplot, which is a comic plot. Today in this lecture, we are going to focus only on main plot, and in the next lecture, we will have a look to the subplot. Now, to understand the different relationships and love story, let us look at the character list. But before that, let us look at some of the key facts about this Jacobean tragedy. It was written in Jacobean age. The setting is elegant. Full title is The Changeling. It was published in 1652 and the literary period is English Renaissance. The setting is in elegant Spain. Okay, now talking about the character list, let us have a look to our first main heroine of this Jacobean tragedy, that is Beatrice. Now talking about the Beatrice, she is sometimes known as Joanna as well. Now this Beatrice Joanna is a high born Spanish girl. Now it is rightly said that don't judge the book by its cover. She has heavenly looks, but talking about her inner nature, she is deceitful. She is the one who is two-faced woman. She is hypocritical woman and insincere woman. Now talking about her name, the name Beatrice means graceful. One who makes others happy. Now it is an allusion to the Beatrice of Dante's Divine Comedy, and Joanna is allusion to the John the Baptist, which represents sacrifice. Now it is an irony that neither of these things is applicable in this case of Beatrice Joanna. Next character is Elsmero. Now talking about Elsmero, he is a Spanish nobleman who is suitor to Beatrice, who is head over heels in love with Beatrice. Next character is Alonso de Peracchio. He is Tommaso's brother, suitor to Beatrice, who is going to marry to Beatrice Joanna. Now next character is Di Flores. Let us look at the antagonist of the play, that is Di Flores. Di Flores, as the name suggests, means Di flower. Di Flores appears ugly and repulsive. Beatrice calls him a basilisk and a toad. His appearance is in stark contrast with Beatrice's beauty. The main storyline begins with the scene where the heroine, Beatrice Joanna, meets a young nobleman named Elsmero. Elsmero, admiring her beauty, falls in love with the heroine at first sight. The beginning of play, audience believes that it is a classic romantic drama. But problem arises when she has promised her father that she will marry a nobleman named Alonso. Beatrice resorts to seek a help from a third party, that is Di Flores. Now talking about Di Flores, his father's servant. Beatrice tells Di Flores to murder Alonso, and instead she will pay him high price by spending night with him. The florist instantly agrees. The florist stabs Alonzo 3 times. And then he cuts off the entire finger with ring intact so that he can show it to the Beatrice Joanna as a proof of work. As a proof of work, when De Flores presents the heroine with severed finger with ring intact, Beatrice suddenly loses her composure and is terrified by this deed. Beatrice and De Flores together in garden are discussing about their crimes. They are unaware that Elsmero is listening to their conversation. Elsmero confronts Beatrice Joanna and De Flores. Now Beatrice confesses her fallen state. Beatrice is stabbed by De Flores, and then De Flores admits that he killed Alonzo and he himself stabbed himself to death. And this is how the play ends with epilogue.